What's up, collectors and pop culture fanatics? Welcome back to the channel. I'm here with my beautiful wife, Heather. We are headed to, we're making a little trip to Nashville to go to Veg Fest. Nashville Veg Fest is a little vegan festival with great food and great people, but there's also a little shop that we like to visit there called Totally Rad Toy House. So we're gonna go there and look around a little bit. We just got here, we gotta pull around back because there's not a lot of parking up front. This little parking lot area. We got some really cool art on the wall. And we're going in. This is the way. Oh, thank you, love. Appreciate it. This is the way.
Hello.
Hello.
What is this? $15, what a steal. I think this is Sideshow and then Hot Toys. That Ray is actually $60. For a complete wicket. 70 for the Leia. 124 for the Luke.
90 for the other.
Rumba. Ewok?
Yes, thank you.
It's a quarter scale Mando and Grogu. That's really cool. I actually really like this one. I thought about getting this, but I didn't because it doesn't scale up to all the other ones. Oh, dude. Oh, it says ask for assistance. That's really cool. I know Mike has these. I didn't see that one though. This Ray actually looks really good. NECA Casey. These are actually really neat. Some old turtles. I might actually buy this. Frieza for $35. It's not bad. Some Dragon Stars. Some Storm collectibles. These are actually pretty dope. I don't really do Gears of War though. See some more turtle stuff. And, oh, that's not headless, that's like a Lego. DC. Aquaman. It's pretty cool looking, actually. I like that. Oh, these are actually really cool. That's a good price for Hella. $20. Looks like she's, oh, this is from the 2-pack, that's why. So she came in a 2-pack with this dude, which is $10. I mean, that's really not bad at all. That's Loki's 20. That's what I've got him priced at for the convention too. ugly cap. It's pretty good. I actually thought about getting this last time. It's a Nemesis. I don't even know what that's from. No gun in it, still $200. That's insane to me. This is $200 and it's missing a part. These are really cool. I've actually got this one for sale. $50 also. It's decent. That's sweet looking. I don't know what that is, but it looks really cool. It's a Bioshock figure. $60. It's like the Build-A-Figure area. Actually, I want that Rhino. Is this Toy Biz MODOK? For $40, that's not bad. The Thanos for $60. Some really cool looking figures in here. Really like that Unmasked Juggernaut too. Got this one. Grundy. $150. Jeez. These. Bunch of select. These are dope. I went to these last time I was in here, like 2 weeks ago. They're actually really cool. Little old Disney stuff. Aladdin and Hercules. This stuff's cool. Furby, oh, that's a boom. Furby boom. I found one thing that I want. Some more pricey select figures. I really like that Spider-Man, but I don't know about $70. It's probably worth it, I just don't know. Some more of these. I think I had this in the box without Cole Obsidian Build-A-Figure piece for, I think I put it at like 25. Something like that. It's not bad. That's a good one. I like that. Jean Grey. Some more Star Wars stuff here. I like that. A lot of glare. Open 6-inch. The Shrew. No, that's the metal one. I'm not a big fan of the metal ones. There it is. $8. Missing a staff. Boss for $15.
As you can tell, it's a different day because I'm in a different outfit. I'm in stop-go traffic, barely moving. So I just got off work. I'm actually headed to Pop Culture Autographs and Collectibles in South Knoxville, here in Knoxville, Tennessee. I just looked at the mic, Knoxville, Tennessee. So my buddy Mike out there, he's the owner of the shop. He's got Blake Best, which was a... he worked production on Friday the 13th. which I thought was really cool. I got to meet Blake at one of our last conventions, MagCon here in Knoxville also. And then Martin Kleba that played Marty from Pirates of the Caribbean. So that's cool. I haven't got a chance to meet Martin yet, so this is a first. He's a good friend of the guys over there, so finally get a chance to meet him after knowing Mike for a couple of years now. But I get to see some people I haven't seen in a minute. I usually do go into pop culture a lot, actually. I really enjoy talking to Mike. He's a cool guy. But I have been in there recently. I went in there recently to get some stuff for my show coming up. Yeah. So this video is coming out a lot later. Today is Friday the 13th, and they're having their event, and it's content, so we're going for it. So hopefully you guys enjoy what's coming up and what you've already seen so far. But like I said, I am in stop-go traffic. I'm at the red light now, so I'm going to hop off here, and we'll see when we get there. Traffic. I despise you, traffic. Now it's raining. Lovely. All right, guys, I just showed up. It's been like literally an hour since I left the shop. So I'm here now. So I'm going to get out and go see my dudes. What up, bro? Be one Kenobi and Han Solo, bro.
I'm scared.
Say hello. Say hello.
What's up, Tyler?
What's up, Yoda? Going in.
Why are you recording?
You're doing a live video.
Started a vlog, bro.
Jeremy. Jeremy.
Hey.
What's up?
No. This is supposed to be a purple sucker. And it's
it's a white one. What's up?
Are you having fun?
I'm vlogging.
You're vlogging.
I'm doing it now.
There you go.
This is the start of something new.
There we go. Heck yeah.
I'm doing a
specific content or anything.
Toy hunting, basically. That's it.
Is that your OnlyFans?
Shameless plug.
You know, if you're going to go with the idea of toy hunting, you need to come up with some ridiculous outfit to do the shit with.
Oh, I will at some point.
You could change your hair color at some point. That's how we do it, remember?
Again?
Again!
That's actually a good idea. You can turn around and based on whatever you're doing, if you're looking for any one thing, change the hair color to match that.
So now what's this get at? Is this just like a, what you call a selfie stick type thing?
It's my phone rig.
But I mean this is, I mean, is it, what's it called?
I don't know.
You don't know. You just bought it.
I just bought it. Yeah, I was going to do a rough walkthrough because of course I'm going to come in here at some point and like actually get into it all.
Go for it.
I would like to open his book. McFarlane. Black Series.
Thank you.
Don't make me put a Freddy.
Old G.I. Joe stuff. This is sick. This big Godzilla fans has got a bunch of that stuff. More old G.I. Joes. These little guys.
It rained and
these are actually really cool.
That is not good.
Figure packs.
So yeah.
They're lying.
I'm good with letting that one slide because that's not cool. So she's having to have her truck and the trailer all.
So many things.
I'm gonna follow you around the store.
It's Dragon Ball.
I have all this, but that one right there.
This one?
Yeah, and you gave me that one.
Come over here.
Oh yeah.
Crawl up Tyler's butt and just hang out.
Oh, that's what's happening. I actually really like this. I thought about getting this one.
Why though?
I don't know. I'd prefer to.
Worst Hulk.
It is. I'd prefer to have a Hot Toys Hulk, but they're a lot more expensive.
You can get the Ragnarok one cheaper than you can the Avengers one.
I like the Ragnarok one. I love it.
It is not. What?
Fred Ward died for Illinois.
Yeah, he died today. Or he died the 8th.
Go this way. This is actually a museum. Stop.
some pretty cool stuff.
It was a different name for the species at one point, and I can't remember what it is off the top of my head.
Got a little bit. Some loose halo.
Yeah.
Why is this so funny?
I bought one of those.
Yeah. Haha! Imagine not having
some vintage Star Wars. That's what I'm talking about. We're getting to like Power of the Force figures right there. It's pretty dope.
I don't have an Xbox.
That is illegal. I don't know. I have a PC. So
your mom's illegal.
They're illegal. These glasses are illegal. You can't.
They probably are. Wait, what is
they're
this?
They're made out of elven urine.
That's a Hank Williams Jr.
They're
thing.
Made out of.
I don't know.
Yeah,
are they made out of frozen elephant urine?
You're.
I'm a minute behind.
Bro,
you.
You're like inside of me. Calm down.
There's some signed figures. This is actually. This one fascinates me. This,
Star Wars.
What is it? What is it?
Star Walls.
Star Walls. So
this figure makes no sense.
I can't. I can't really
see.
Supposed
to be, but she's not.
But it says Star Walls. It's a what do they call them? Like a knockoff.
It's like rip-off.
A misprint.
No, it's not a misprint because
it's a knockoff.
A Shrek print.
It's Star
Walls. JRH Customs is my dude, Jeremy.
Is that really Star Walls?
Buy one, get one 50% off on these custom figures.
Exactly. My father makes them, and I help sometimes when it comes to it.
My father.
Dude, this Loki?
Gabe!
Sorry.
Rude. These figures are sick,
sure
actually.
Is. I helped him with
these are actually really cool. Some I don't even know who makes these Diamond Select toys. These are actually older. Let's see. This looks like it's from Clone Wars. Grand Admiral Thrawn. Let's see. See if we can find a year on this, just out of curiosity. I don't see a year on this.
That's the only one I see.
Palpatine. Luke Skywalker. This one's actually really sick. This clone trooper down here. Is that supposed to be a 501st trooper?
Yes. Super intense Minecraft player.
I think so.
Ooh, Dengar. That's a sweet one. These are all like older statues. These are really cool, actually. This is only $30. It's a hammerhead bust. Zuckus. Get out of here. Get out of here.
Just edit it away.
I'm going to fight you.
That's the best one. Darth Vader's cool. But he can't beat Niles.
Hey guys, I just got back home. As you can tell, Blake Best wasn't there. He had to go set up for a convention somewhere. I believe it was in Knoxville. I'm not sure. I'll be in Nashville, so I don't know. But I'm a little irritated because the mic issues. I know you guys heard the little bit of static. I apologize. Please don't unsubscribe or not watch any more videos because of that. It's a learning process. That mic is dog water. It is gone. I'm not using it anymore, so no worries about that. I'll just, for now, I'll be using the audio that's on the device itself and not using an additional audio accessory. But hopefully at some point I will be getting a better mic, something that I can use and rely on, because after listening to the video, I was like, whoops, that sucks. But yeah, sorry about that. All right, guys, I'm back home. We went to Totally Rad Toy House in Nashville and also Pop Culture in Knoxville. It wasn't a super eventful video, but we did get to see a couple of places that we haven't seen just yet. There will be a lot more of Pop Culture on this channel because I do go in there often. So I'm going to start with my pickup from Totally Rad Toy House, which I ended up with the Frieza 4th Form from SH Figure Arts. It's a really good looking figure. So I looked this up
And it's around $50 on eBay right now. And those are sold prices. That's what I always go off of, is the first three sold listings. Got this one for about $38 out the door. But this is really for a friend of mine. I kind of bought it to see if it would fit in the collection. And it doesn't really fit with the amount of room that I have. So it's going to a friend of mine, Tyler, which you saw in the last videos. But you can see here, this is my Dragon Ball Z area, and it's pretty loaded up. So that's the only thing that I picked up from Totally Rad, but I did, and this is stuff for my shows to set up. But I got some 12-inch Hasbro and Kenner from my buddy Mike at Pop Culture.
Do it.
His fingers are articulated. That's pretty cool. I don't know why. That's the one little... Interesting. Cool. All right. But his other hand is like straight up. Just...
Bah. Do it now.
I don't know. Actually got to see Ian McDermott at ICCCon earlier this month, which was really cool. So I got quite a bit from my buddy Mike. I guess we can kind of go through the pickups because that's kind of the point. But this older, I think this is actually a Kenner Vader, but if you kind of slap him around a little bit, I think he talks. Maybe it's the other one. Maybe. We'll see. His helmet does come off, which is really cool. These would be really neat for some customs. I'm not going to do any customs with these just because it's basically just inventory for my shows to set up, but I think that these actually look really good for what they are. You know, older Kenner and Hasbro 12-inch figures. And if you guys, I know a lot of people that collect hot toys, such as myself. I love them. There are some Hasbro figures that can't really hold a candle to hot toys, but can get very close. Like if you missed out on the Count Dooku, which... I didn't miss out on Dooku, I just didn't see the point in getting him. He's not one of my favorite figures. I do have a Episode 3 Yoda down here, if you can see him. Right, where's my finger going? Right here? Oh my, the direction of where I'm, right there. So, I do have Episode 3 Yoda, he looks really cool. Dooku would go great with him, but I have the Hasbro Dooku downstairs in my like store glass displays, and he is really good looking. Now the quality of the figure itself is really good. I think the face looks amazing, but it's just, I don't know, I think it would go okay with those. But here's another one that I picked up, a little Jango Fett from Hasbro. This was a deluxe set that they had done. Now there are some kind of, now these I'm planning on selling fairly cheap because there are missing parts. There's kind of stuff that I can't get off of them, and you know, I am a customizer, so I could just paint these things up, but honestly I would still sell them fairly cheap, so I didn't really see the point. But for customizers, I think these would go great. You have the Tamiya Morrison head sculpt, which actually doesn't look that bad. And since I've got this out, I want to compare this one to the Cody head sculpt from Hot Toys. Just because I think it would be interesting to do. So... Now, clearly there's a huge difference in what you see here, but the likeliness is still there. You can still tell that the Hasbro one is Tamiya Morrison. So obviously, you know, that one's gonna take it for sure. Which I would hope so, because this one was like $40 in a set with everything, and then Cody was $265, I think. So there's a huge difference there. And if you're looking behind me going, wow, that looks cool. Thank you. I've tried really hard with my collection. I put a lot of money into my stuff. I'm very proud of the things I have, and eventually I will do a collection tour. Right now I just have to kind of set things up and get them more organized, because if you can't tell, the top of my shelves are kind of just everything everywhere. And I've got Storm Collectibles, NECA Turtles, and a bunch of Black Series and DC Collectibles, everything all over the place. But this is a pretty decent figure here. And I actually have another one of these in my lot of stuff to sell at the conventions. He's a lot more complete than this one. He's got pretty much everything, including his helmet, except for one of the shin guards, which I think is hilarious because this one has this one, and I think that's the same one that they're both missing. So, I don't know. Then, here's the other... Oh! Wow, that was a long... God, that was a long saber fight there. So this one, oh, here we go. 1997 Lucasfilm, so this is Kenner. This one has to be Kenner. And then this one, 1997? I guess they're both, are these the same thing? No, they look different. Okay, so these are both made by Kenner. One is electric. Oh, look at you with my own eyes. And this one doesn't talk. I don't think, unless the batteries are broken or something. Which, I don't even know how you get in there. But if you can look, you can see kind of a difference in their pants. Which, like I said, there's a couple of spots that are flaking on the pleather, and this one actually has cloth, so I think this one's probably the better choice. Oh, there you go. His whole thing pops off, which is, this is the exact same head sculpt as the other one. No. Just kidding. Stop it. Okay. The flow of that cape. Does this one flow like that? Oh yeah. Same exact material, which this is wild because I have I have this one right now, which like I said is for the show. Whoops. This one, which is also for the show. And then this accessory lot for the interchangeable Vader Anakin set, I guess. So I don't think I actually have, I didn't notice, but Anakin's face has been chewed. He's got like but this one does look really cool. This is like post burn, obviously, you know, right there on Mustafar. There's Vader's suit. So if you have the body, you can switch these out. I guess, like I said, these all sell fairly cheap at the convention. This bag right here with two lightsabers, the body, the Vader panels, the pieces, the boots, the hands, whoops, the robotic hand, all of these from This stuff from Hasbro, the two head sculpts, which obviously the Anakin one is kind of useless due to the fact that it's been chewed off by something. You know, also there's like this piece for his neck piece and his neck piece and his face mask. Really looks neat. This set doesn't have the dome that goes on top, but you know, all of this right here, these Jedi boots, it's all gonna be probably $10. And really the only thing bad about it is Anakin's face has been chewed off and you've got this and a Darth Vader helmet and suit and all that, so why not just make a Darth Vader? Or finish scraping some stuff off of that and I don't know what you could do with that, honestly. That's probably trash, but still, like I said, the whole bag for like $10 or so. If I had seen this bag for $10 and I didn't have a Vader already, I probably would go ahead and customize one. But also, these Vaders are probably going to be like $12 or so. So why not just buy a Vader? And this one, also, and like I said before, all of these are from Mike at Pop Culture. He gave me a good deal on these. He's trying to help me get my stuff going. So this one I remember having when I was a kid. It's a very ugly, stout-looking stormtrooper with this giant sensor in the middle. It's got a couple of different settings on it, a little battery pack in the back with a couple of buttons. It says alarm, off, and game. Basically, you have a bright orange blaster that is Han Solo's pistol, and you can set this guy up in a different room. You turn corners and shoot at him, and it's like, and he'll say, blast him. I don't, kind of cool. That's probably going to be like $5. I don't know. Just because there's no articulation, it doesn't have the gun, the batteries are bad, or it could be corroded inside, I don't know, but this is one of those that I just throw in there, and it's cheap for somebody who wants to deal with it, or, you know, if you don't want to buy any Hot Toys troopers, you can just set this guy in the back of Darth Vader and have him look a little, I don't know, I'd say he probably would scale up, actually. So I've got a Vader and Boba down there. Probably put him just in the back. I don't know. Just random stuff. Now this is from, this is a very interesting looking one. I had to search for his stuff before. This is from 1998. Playing Mantis was the company that made this. This is Dr. Evil. Very gross looking, let me get out of the way. Very gross looking, weird little zombie type. I don't even know. I have no idea. His articulation's fairly decent, though. He can do the whole arm cross thing and kind of have to work with a little bit, but yeah. He's got like all this. His little tiny flip-flops are funny, which I'm surprised these are still on him because when we got this out of the box, you know, there's just all kinds of stuff laying in there, so. Oh yeah, this guy I looked up and I think from what I saw he was like $30-$40 online, somewhere in the box, somewhere out. He has a little ray gun that he comes with, so this would probably be like $10 in a bag. That's gonna probably be like a niche market for somebody who would want that Dr. Evil, but still a neat looking figure. This dude I was told is from Resident Evil. Now I absolutely love Resident Evil, but I'm not exactly sure who this guy is. I'm assuming he's from the video games. But Mike told me he's just some dude from Resident Evil, and he kind of looks cool. It'd be great for a custom figure if you want to take his jacket off. You got his boots and his black pants. You just gotta, I guess I can do it. Just wipe his pants off a little bit. There's a little bit of lint on there. But it's really weird. I'm assuming this is a sideshow. But he's got the little belt buckle things just like glued to the shirt. It looks kind of funny. I don't know. couple of paint rub off there, but again, a little bit of black paint, something like that. I don't know. Then we have Princess Leia. I'm assuming this is a Kenner figure. She's got something right there on her dress. But other than that, there's some stuff on the back of her dress. I mean, again, it's a $5 figure. It'll be in there. These are 12-inch if you've got, you know, if you've got other clothing that you would want to put Leia in, or you want to use this clothing for something. Like I said, there's a little bit of mark there. It might be able to come off. It might not. I don't know exactly. But for $5, you know, somebody may be willing to grab it. And if I was doing customs with stuff like this, I would jump on $5 for it just because it's $5. But the hood doesn't really do much. But her hair is actually still intact extremely well. The buns are nice and tight. Her face is not messed up in any way. I mean, other than like the sculpting, obviously. But I just mean, you know, the figure itself, it's not all Anakin, you know, rubbed off nose and stuff. But yeah, white boots. So, you know, that'd be good for something. $5 figure, like I said. And then last but not least, everybody's absolute favorite Star Wars character has gotta be this guy right here. And you know who I'm talking about? It's Jar Jar Binks.
What did you say? Mooey, mooey.
You say my again.
So, this guy actually looks pretty cool. I had this one for a while. Fun fact, when I lived with my mom, we actually had a house fire back in around 2009. So a lot of stuff that I had got kind of ruined, either from the water putting it out or just the fire itself. But this guy did kind of put me back in my child mindset, where I had these different types of figures. And I did have quite a bit of 12-inch just because I do like the doll style figures. And excuse me, that's what brought me into my love for Hot Toys, along with Josh Pence, one of my favorite YouTubers. He's pretty cool. I'll put his stuff in the description here. But yeah, he kind of got me into Hot Toys when I started watching them a couple years back. So my first one was actually this John Wick up here, in which I have like a weapons wall. I made a desk out of wood, caulking, nails, glue. It's all legit wood. And then right behind me, I made another one with, I don't know how well you can see that with the glare, but it is Stan Lee. It's supposed to be Stan Lee's office. So I'll actually pull this up here. I'm pretty proud of this one. This was a more recent setup that I did. But you got Cap and Stan Lee and Paul Rudd in there, Robert Downey Jr., all the Avengers stuff in the back. He's got his toys and writing and all that. A custom Ebony Maw from my friend Jeremy. He just kind of gave that one to me just because it was something that somebody had made and it didn't really fit anything he was doing. So he was just like, hey, you can have that. And I was like, oh, that would probably go well with the Stan Lee display. So, and it actually does look really cool, kind of just in the corner there, just laying on the floor. I thought it was neat. So, the only thing that I don't like about using pleather, which I don't use leather anything anyways, but this is like, if you can't see this already just from rubbing off on my hands, is the pleather bits that are on here just kind of flaking. But again, a $5 figure. If you want a naked Jar Jar or pantsless Jar Jar, it's a... just kidding. I don't know. I don't know what you want to do with it. It's just not something I can use, and maybe somebody at some point comes by and they're like, oh man, a Jar Jar, cool, I'll take it. $5? Sure. You know, so it's just one of those things. But That is all I picked up this weekend from Totally Rad and Pop Culture Autographs and Collectibles. And I know, as you saw in the video, Pop Culture, the address was on there. Totally Rad, the address is on there. So if you need to, go back, write the address down, save the video, like and subscribe, share the video if you enjoyed the content. I really appreciate it to all of you watching. And, you know, liking the video helps, subscribing absolutely helps, sharing helps, any bits of help. I'm not asking for money in any way. Just press a button. That's all it takes to get a content creator out and a little more known. This is something that I love doing. I love making videos. I love messing with action figures. I at some point would like to start that's what I'm doing now, is setting up a conventions and stuff to sell my work and to sell action figures to save up for a bus, because I want to make a toy bus, basically, that can travel around to different places and set up at conventions and stuff. So, if you guys are in with that type of stuff, stay tuned. I'll have another video out at some point within the next couple weeks or so. I hope you enjoyed the last video. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you all for watching. And as always, remember, collect what you love.